If someone were to have told you 6-7 years ago that over 1 billion people would be on Facebook today, and that Facebook would in essence become the largest community in the history of mankind, you would have said, well, there's no way. But that's exactly what happened. And today, every brand out there has prioritized keeping up with their Facebook community, which is great. Facebook has served a valuable role in evolving community, but it's not the end of the evolution, it's just the beginning. And the first brand to pioneer into those uncharted waters will win in a whole new way. So how do you get ahead of it? How do you evolve your community to what's next? Those are the questions you should be asking yourself.
And I think because of that, then these things that we call communities, right? I mean, if you take that root commune, you've got a commonness. We like to stress the commonness of that experience, but I think it masks a lot of internal contradictions. There's a lot of paradox when you start to talk about community. So I kind of see community not as something that evolves through a series of stages, but something that comes together for a very specific period of time and then breaks apart again and reconfigures in different ways.
So you're Purina Cat Chow. You're one of the most successful brands in the social space in all of Nestle. You've built a large community with close to 700,000 highly engaged cat people on your Facebook page, or what you affectionately refer to as the world's first digital cat park. And they're sharing stories, and they're liking, and they're commenting. And yet, you want more. You sense this change coming. You don't know what, you don't know when, but you're sure it's coming. So what do? You get curious. You start listening to people who think of community outside the lens of a brand.
There's conversations happening across the web, and you gotta know where to find them, you gotta understand how those more niche communities work. And you have to know the language and you have to know the etiquette. So if you're jumping into a forum where people are talking about your product and you don't speak the language, meaning you're not referring to people or moderators or culture in the same way, you'll get laughed out of the room, the proverbial internet room, you know. So you have to, your marketers and your social strategists have to spend time. You gotta live on these networks in order to understand them.
I think one of the things that's important for people to feel loyal to a community is for people to have a role in the community. And roles can be either active or passive. If you think about the roles people are playing in a brand community, you might have people that play the role of greeter, that they welcome new members when they see them join. People that play the role of storyteller, that are telling the story of the brand or of how this community evolved. And along those same lines, something else that can help a community persist and build loyalty is this idea of rituals and traditions. So you may have someone who shares what are the rituals and traditions. And the rituals and traditions can center around the brand, can center around a product. They can be jargon that's unique to that particular brand or that particular group.
I think the way that's going to turn out is that you're going to see these virtual communities start to exist in a large way in what I would term as like cohorts. So you'll have these groups of people in different parts of the world that are connecting face to face but also connecting virtually in a larger network. And so they're going to be able to get that physical connection and know that there are people that are connected to them in their communities or in their towns or in their villages or in their cities that they can kind of come together with. And then that connection is also going to be to that larger network across the country, across the globe.
Different ways that we all celebrate that pride.
Curiosity can only get you so far. Breakthroughs happen when you give yourself permission to wrestle with the curiosity, to explore paths you might not normally go down, to have a strong point of view while at the same time being comfortable with the fact that everything you think may in fact be completely wrong. That's a hack session. It's hard work. It's not for everyone. But it's here where the future lies waiting to be discovered. The final thing about curiosity to keep in mind is this. You have to have the conviction to follow where it leads you. So, to that end, here is how you follow your curiosity about the future of the Purina Cat Chow community. One, you declare and continually reinforce your pride in being the brand for cat people. Two, you connect with your community around more than your mutual love of cats. You get to know the smaller groups in your community and learn more about the other shared passions you have. Three, you build an experience that lets your community get to know each other more individually. Four, you monitor your community's social behavior and keep up with the new and most used channels, making sure to use them the way they were meant to be used. And five, you give them a way to work and join together to make a difference and recognize leaders that can help your joint cause.
My biggest hope for community going forward is community isn't a place to gather, but something to take with you. So I think my dream is that every cat owner will have an element of this community in their pocket, whether it's a mobile device, a card, a badge, a coin, whatever it might be, but something that connects them to the people around them, whether next door or around the world, who are passionate about cats and can share those experiences together. That is the modern definition, in my opinion, of community and something that this brand needs to pioneer.